Greetings, and this is LGR Oddware, where we're taking a look at hardware and software that is forgotten, obsolete, and so very, very odd sometimes. Like today's thing. This is the original Sexy Mouse desktop entertainer. Yep, we're actually covering this. It's vaguely mouse-shaped, but no, it really does look like someone just took a doll and lopped off the arms, legs, and head. You got like a decapitation and quadruple amputee thing going on. I guess if that's your fetish, this is your mouse. Or if you're really into women that look vaguely mouse-like, dressing up in stripper outfits, and you're some sort of janitor cat with eyes that refuse to stay inside of your skull, then this is also your thing. I love this sticker. Buy me GE/Sanyo batteries. Why? There are no batteries required in this thing. What for? Are you going to be doing something else that you need batteries for? And in that case, I just don't want to know. Moving around to the bag here, and well, you can see that somebody actually paid $20 for this thing, and well, that was not me. I got this for a couple bucks on eBay when somebody sent me a link to it and said this would make fine oddware, and well, they were right about that. This is odd. But yeah, it's listed as a gag gift, and yeah, I mean, that's what this is. This is a straight-up gag gift that you would find in like a store like Spencer's or something. Not meant to be serious, so I'm not gonna treat this too seriously, and you know, we gotta have a mouse pad to go with my sexy mouse. Though I don't really know, because these people thankfully don't exist anymore. Although, do they? Because if you go on Amazon and look, you can actually still find a USB version of the Sexy Mouse. They all come from, like, China and Japan and whatnot, and I guess that's not too surprising. And from what I'm seeing here, it does indeed get worse, so count your blessings, I suppose. And there is actually a male version of the Sexy Mouse. You have a male torso instead. Open up the Sexy Mouse package and you get the Sexy Mouse desktop entertainer. Anyway, the mouse itself, it's, well, it's a mouse. You got a Sexy Mouse logo on the side, a standard ball underneath because this is an older school ball mouse, and a PS2 connector on the end as well as a converter for serial. So we're gonna try this out on an older computer with a serial port, see how it does. Oh yeah, and of course the whole point of this is being able to click. Last thing I want to look at here is this technical information on the back before we go and try this out. You got some basic stuff here, 400 DPI, optomechanical encoder, dynamic resolution, fast tracking, blah blah blah, who cares? And then there's this one other technical feature. Avoid use in direct sunlight. Well, we'll see about that. We're in direct sunlight. In fact, we're in the direct outdoors, which is normally against my religion as a geeky gamer, indoors type guy, but, well, here we go. Got the 386 NCR system, and the Sexy Mouse is hooked up in direct sunlight. Oh, noes. And, let's see what we got here. I swear this computer is turned on, and there is actually stuff on the screen, but, well, sunlight is kind of a problem. So, let's go to the mouse directory, and I think, oops, mouse. So it says the mouse driver is now installed, so we should be ready to go. All right, let's play some Arkanoid. Always a good thing to try out a mouse with, and once again, you probably can't see crap. But it's EGA mode. It's detected the mouse, so mouse is initialized. Alright, so if the mouse is working, we should just be able to click the left, or I guess right, boob, and we should be into the game. Aha! So, it does work in direct sunlight. Or does it? Well, it clicks. It clicks in direct sunlight. Okay, geez, Arkanoid. Stop. Does it work? Let's go into like a paint program. All right. Got Mouse Systems PC Paint here, and Daggone it. It doesn't work with this either. Maybe it's because I'm in direct sunlight. Oh, man. This is so stupid. Nah, it just doesn't work. I mean, that figures, right? Well... Oh, man. Well, I guess maybe I should try it on another computer with indirect sunlight and see how that goes. Okay, so we're out of the sunlight, back inside on a computer that's a slight bit more modern, on a Windows machine, and the mouse is over there looking stupid. So let's go ahead and try a game out. We're going to be playing Slave Zero. All right, and as you can see, it works perfectly fine. In fact, there's no problems with this mouse at all, except really for the shape. But it does at least work like a mouse, and that's good. And, man, honestly, I just really like Slave Zero, so it really kind of doesn't matter what I'm playing it with. Although I guess the Dreamcast port was pretty crap, so never mind, I take that back. It is definitely made to be like a left-handed mouse, I guess, at least with the shape of this torso bosom area. And I really just don't even know why it said to not use it in direct sunlight. Like, seriously, what the heck is that? Why? In all seriousness, it probably has something to do with, like, maybe the plastic. You know, I know a lot of plastics don't do well in sunlight. Or maybe it's that optoelectrical sensor. The sunlight creeps through there and screws it up, makes it not work. But yeah, I mean, it works just fine, which is surprising to me. Once you get used to the tatas being so out there, it actually feels all right, which is weird. Even as a right-handed person, my pinky and ring finger actually slide right into this part above the hip. This game is cool, though. Recently released on GOG. I don't know if I mentioned that already, but it has been, so I would highly recommend it. In fact, I should review this at some point. Die already, you dumb robot. I just killed you with a sexy mouse. Now that right there, that's pretty devastating. Alright, well that's pretty much it. The sexy mouse is a, wow. What the heck else do I even say about this thing? I don't know. Except that, this exists. And if you've made it this far, then I apologize for the awkwardness on behalf of this company. Seriously, they have made my day supremely weird, or shall I say odd. So I'm not sure if I should thank them or shun them entirely. And if you'd like some more videos of odd things, sexy or otherwise, then feel free to check out some of my other videos. I create more of them every week. Feel free to subscribe if you want to be notified when those occur, or you can always follow me on Twitter, Facebook, or Patreon, the latter of which gets you videos earlier than you get them anywhere else, which is cool if you would like to see things such as the sexy mouse come earlier than it will for everyone else. Pun only slightly intended. Oh my goodness, I gotta stop this now. Thank you for watching.